So what drew me to becoming a researcher was that as a kid, I always enjoyed solving puzzles. And I'm very fortunate that I can solve puzzles and get paid for it. So this is a very fulfilling and rewarding career. And I really also enjoy understanding how we work. How does the body do what it does? What is physiology? How do all the organ systems connect? And what drives those connections and what drives those interactions? And if you drill down deep enough, you'll find that metabolism pretty much runs the show. And so what is the major organelle inside of a cell that is responsible for metabolism? Well, that's mitochondria. And as we know from high school biology, mitochondria are the powerhouse of the cell. My research is about mitochondrial bioenergetics with a focus on calcium handling and free radical homeostasis. Mitochondrial bioenergetics is the area of study that looks at how mitochondria transduce energy that's stored in food and converts it to energy that's usable by the cell. Calcium overload is an important phenomenon to study because it's intertwined in so many diseases that we study today. It's involved in cardiovascular disease, neurodegenerative diseases, as well as various liver and kidney disorders. So we are trying to rewire mitochondrial metabolic machinery in an advantageous way to mitigate all these detrimental effects caused by the diseases. The current challenge our lab is trying to address is to shed new light on a decades-old problem that has plagued the field. This problem is a phenomenon known as mitochondrial permeability transition. And essentially what it does, if you think of mitochondria as batteries for your cells, this phenomenon, mitochondrial permeability transition, short circuits the battery. So the ultimate goal of our lab's research is to identify novel therapeutics and strategies to mitigate the detrimental consequences of calcium overload, which triggers excessive free radical generation and then precipitates this mitochondrial permeability transition phenomenon. And when that occurs, the cell dies. And when the cell dies, that leads to organ failure. And when organs fail, people die. And I don't want people to die. This work would be next to impossible without the gracious help of Kristen Parent, the director of MSU's cryo-electron microscope facility. Before this project was awarded, I first approached Kristen and asked her if we could image mitochondria in her cryo-electron microscope. When Kristen responded to my emails, she was a little bit skeptical. She was skeptical because she thought the mitochondria were too big to image in the cryo-electron microscope. So she studies the Samba virus as well as other viruses. The Samba virus is rather large, on the order of mitochondria, so I thought we had a chance. And I'm happy to report, on our very first attempt, we successfully imaged mitochondria in exquisite detail. The next thing was the test was whether or not we can visualize mitochondria loaded with calcium. When I was a postdoc at U of M, I discovered that when you load mitochondria with sufficient calcium, you impair their ability to synthesize ATP. ATP is frequently referred to as the energy currency of a cell. And this impairment was not linked to this mitochondrial permeability transition phenomenon. It is something new. Again, I'm happy to report that our very first attempt was successful, and we were able to identify and visualize what's known as calcium phosphate precipitates or granules embedded in the matrix of the mitochondria. We also noticed that the mitochondrial membrane was significantly remodeled, and the structural information that we gathered from the cryo-electron microscope images correlated strongly with the functional outcomes that we saw in the lab. Once we saw the images on screen, we were blown away. We were surprised at the exquisite detail that we could resolve, as well as the presence of these calcium phosphate granules. When we saw these images, we knew we were onto something big. So recently, Kristen shared some excellent news with me. She was tenacious and convinced the higher administration to invest more money in the cryo-electron microscope facility because with the new equipment that Kristen secured, we will be able to peer deeper into living tissue than ever before. And my hope is to discover, identify these calcium phosphate granules in the mitochondria in living cardiac myocytes or heart cells. And once we confirm that, it will be an absolute game changer for the field. So I've been fortunate to work with some amazing people, in particular, my graduate students. They're very helpful, they're hard workers. They sometimes work too hard. They have been a source of inspiration as well as humility for me throughout these years. And one of my team members has recently decided to forgo their medical school aspirations and to pursue a PhD in my lab, my grad students are amazing. So I'm truly honored to be a part of this institution that allows and enables cutting-edge research, such as mine, to further advance our goals and to improve human healthcare.